Hi everybody, I'm Pastor Susan and welcome to day 5 of our week-long series on signs in the Gospel of John. We have been journeying with Jesus, especially in this last week, through some of his last words to his disciples, words that he wanted to make sure that they remembered after he left because he knew it was going to be a hard time. And so we're now in chapter 16 and he's talking, and some of the disciples are getting pretty upset. They're getting troubled by this. What does it mean that soon you're not going to see me, and after that you'll see me, and because I'm going to the Father, I will come to you. They were really getting kind of confused, and so Jesus, knowing what they wanted to ask him, said these words. Are you trying to find out from each other what I meant when I said, soon you won't see me and soon after that you will see me? I assure you that you're going to cry and lament and the world will be happy. You will be sorrowful, but your sorrow will be turned into joy. When a woman gives birth, she has pain because her time has come. But when the child is born, she's no longer remembering the distress because of her joy of having the child. In the same way, you will have sorrow now, but I will see you again, and you will be overjoyed, and no one can take away your joy. In that day, you won't ask me anything. I assure you that the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. Up to now, you have nothing. You've asked nothing in my name. Ask and you will receive, so that your joy will be complete. And then I just want to read verse 33 because it's one of the ones that really speaks to my heart. And it says, I have said these things to you so that you will have peace in me. In the world, you will have distress, but be encouraged. Why? Because I have overcome the world. Today I want us to be reminded of a couple of things, and that is that you and I can receive peace and have courage and faith in the midst of tough times. Having courage and faith and peace in the midst of tough times seems sometimes difficult, sometimes if not impossible. But I think that these words of Jesus are especially important to us during these times when there's so much uncertainty, when there's so much sorrow and grief, when there's worry and stress and fear. To remember these words of Jesus to his disciples can take on new meaning for us today. Jesus promised that we would never be left alone. He promised that even in times when we are having very difficult times, that he will be with us. And to lean into our faith during these times, because Jesus has overcome the world. The way that he showed us how to live is a way that leads to life. And we get to be a part of that life-giving continued presence for ourselves, but also for the world. Lean into your faith today. I don't know what you're going through, but I know that in my life, there are many challenges right now. And the remembrance in these words of Jesus is to remember to lean into faith, to trust in the God who will provide us with hope and with life and with peace. May it be so. May we confess and believe and then act on our belief in this one who gives us life. Amen and amen.